Hello and welcome to iNurture videos. In this video, we will be discussing on the development of Azure applications. After completing this video, you will be able to create a web app inside a Microsoft Azure.
It's the Microsoft's cloud platform. So right here, I have just went to portal.azure.com and logged into my subscription. As you can see, this is the new portal of Microsoft Azure, and to create a new web app so you can publish your website or your app on the cloud, you can hit right here, new, and we can go to web and mobile, and then we're gonna hit web app. So there's gonna be a new blade here that's gonna be opened. I'm not gonna go to the very specific details of the implementation here. So you can check what is an app service plan, what is the resource group in our further videos. So I'm right here, I'm just gonna put a unique URL across all the Azure websites.net domain. So I'm gonna put my own name, Felipe Barreiros, and okay, it's available. I'm gonna create a new app service plan. So app service plan one, and a new resource group. So RG1, for example, and the pricing tier, this is important. We recommend you to start on standard because it's not going to have a quota limitation of the amount of CPU, or there is an extended amount of storage you have as well. So this is just for trying Azure, and then we can go and create a free. We have a quota limitation here, so if you exceed this quota, you're gonna have problems. So this is just for testing, so it's cool. So it's not enabling me to create, so I'm gonna create a new one because I have changed the pricing tier. And let's see if it goes. Okay. Then I just hit create and wait a little bit so I can see my new web app. You can see from two places here that the web app is being created. The first one is right here on the right side. It's creating a web app. You can see everything going on. Or you can go to your notifications pane and you can see everything that is going on your Azure subscription. This is a beautiful place to go on and check if you have any errors, if you have any updates coming in, or you have anything going on your subscription. So this is a good place to go every time you have your portal opened. So we're going to wait a little bit and see if our web app gets created. Okay, and now that we have created and we have a success message there, we have our web app. This is a blade that we can see all the details of our web app. And here we have the resource group, everything that we have just created, and also the URL and the username of the FTP deployment you're going to use. So if you're going to deploy your web app using FTP, this is the username you're going to use. And there are also more settings here. You can scroll down as well. And right now, I'm just going to click here and check if our website is working and if we can browse it. I'm using Internet Explorer. So let's see if it gets back. Yes, and that there is my website. So this is a web app has been successfully created.
Thank you for watching this video.